Hi, I'm Marcus with theindiemusiclab.com. So today we're gonna take a look at 6 of the best delay effects for indie productions. Now, let me just mention this real quick for the sake of clarity. So the way that I'm setting up my delays is by using what are called return tracks, or in my case, I'm using Studio One. It's called an effects channel. Every DAW has this capability of using return tracks. So what's happening is instead of inserting the delay directly on the track and then adjusting the mix knob or the dry wet knob, instead of that, you're setting up a return track or return channel over here with the delay on it, which allows you to then send the vocal track or whatever track it is to that delay. And this way of doing it gives you much more customization capabilities and control over how exactly you want that delay to sound. Now, as you'll see, there are a couple exceptions, but for the most part, this is the technique that I'm using. So without further ado, let's jump right in and let's look at the 6 best delay effects for indie productions. Delay effect number 1 is the WASHY slap delay. So unlike a basic slap delay sound, which sounds like this, that sounds great, right? But what about when you want to make that sound be more washed out and warbly, if you will? Well, to get that is quite simple. First, start with the slap delay, obviously, which is a very simple concept of having the left and the right sides of the delay be slightly offset so you get some stereo width. And then the feedback at 0, so it only slaps back once. And I also got the high cut and the low cut filters active here to warm up the sound. Then, to get the washy effect, we're gonna add 2 plugins to this delay channel, a chorus and a reverb. The chorus is at 100% mix, so it's really adding that effect. And then the reverb is at 50% mix, so it takes half of that chorusy delay signal and washes it out even more, which results in this sound. It was fun. Delay effect number 2 is the dotted eighth note delay. So a dotted eighth note is probably my favorite when it comes to the timing of a delay. This works especially well on vocals and electric guitar. Have a listen. Is it steep as a storm? Such recovery. So here's the delay settings. I have a bit of the drive and the modulation active here, feedback at 80%, and a little low cut and high cut filtering happening as well. Then, as I frequently love to do on delay channels, I added a reverb after the delay, and this really helps that delay signal have more dimension in the mix. And then finally, I'm using a sidechain compressor, which I have linked to the vocal, and what this does is it ducks the delay signal out of the way when the lead vocal is singing and then brings it back up to full volume whenever there are gaps in the vocal. This is a key benefit, by the way, of putting your delays on a return track rather than a direct insert. All the noise at the door, such a revelry. Well, it's hooked inside of everything you said to me. Now, here's another example of a dotted eighth note delay, but this time on a guitar track. So, this is a guitar remake of the song Apocalypse by Cigarettes After Sex. Now for this, since I'm using the virtual amp plugin called Ampire inside of Studio One, I did go ahead and just add the delay as a pedal inside this software. So this is one exception to the rule of putting delays on a return channel. In this instance, it's just directly on the track. So after the amp, the chorus pedal, and the dotted eighth delay pedal, we're sending that sound through a crap ton of reverb. So here's what that sounds like all together. Delay effect number 3 is the constant ghost delay. So what I'm calling the constant ghost delay is the type of delay that you want to feel more than you hear. This is especially for vocals, and generally you want either an eighth or a quarter note delay time, and it's just there very subtly adding that extra bit of color and dimension to your mix. So here's an example of what this could sound like. Drifting in and out, you see the road you're on. So here are the delay settings. We've got a quarter note delay, 60% feedback with a bit of low cut and high cut. Then, as per usual, we got a 2 second or so plate reverb after the delay, mix at around 50%, and finally a sidechain compressor, which again is there to duck out of the way of the lead vocal. Now the volume of the delay signal is very important here. Remember, you want to feel it more than you hear it. It's never as it seems. Help me, baby. Help me, baby. Okay, delay effect number 4 is the filtered call and response delay throw. Now we're getting into using automation on our delays. So here's what this filtered call and response sound sounds like, and then we'll talk about this long ass list of plugins I got here. So before you freak out about the number of plugins on this delay chain, just know that this was all in the moment creative experimentation. I added one thing and then I felt like it needed a little bit of this, a bit of that, right? So don't necessarily copy all of these extracurricular plugins verbatim, but I will walk you through all of these real quick just so you can get a feel for it. So here's what I did. I started out with a whole note delay, very low feedback. I got some extra drive turned up here, and I have the high cut filter all the way down to below 4K, so it warms it up. Then I got the saturation knob blasted, so that adds some nice, almost guitar amp sort of drive to this delay vocal sound, which sounds really cool. Then I threw OTT on here, depth at 30%. This adds a bit of nice compression and extra glue. Then a little reverb to add some more space. Then some EQ, mostly using this as a more fine-tuned filter than what I did inside of the delay plugin. And then some more distortion with this stock distortion in Studio One. And finally, this free auto pan plugin called Pancake to give that delayed vocal a bit of movement so it kind of swims between the left and the right speakers. Now, one more thing. Like I said, we're using automation, which means this delay sound is only activated during specific vocal lines. So as you can see here on my vocal track, I'm sending this to the whole delay, which is over on the return channel. But I have this active button automated. That way I can have it be turned on only during those select vocal phrases. Alright, so we got two more delay effects to get to. Before we do that though, real quick, I just want to let you know about my free guide, The 5 Steps to a Spotify Level Production. It's 100% free, so go grab a copy for yourself. This is really going to help you get an understanding of the framework, the step-by-step process of how do you take a basic idea and then build that song out and take it from start to finish and make it so good that it belongs in an official Spotify playlist. That is the goal. I want you to be able to make music that sounds so good that if people discover it on Discover Weekly or a top Spotify playlist, it feels like it belongs there. And that is what this guide is going to help you accomplish. So the link is in the description. It's 100% free. All right, let's move on to the final two delay effects. Delay effect number 5 is the left to right mirror delay. So this is a really cool sound. What's happening is I have the original guitar track panned to one side, and then I have this exact track duplicated, except this has an eighth note delay on it and the mix at 100%. So it's just the delay signal and it's panned to the opposite side. And finally, delay effect number 6 is the Anthemic snare drum slap delay effect. This slap delay on a snare drum sound is one of my favorite production moves of all time. I'm gonna play you a song by the Naked and Famous, and listen to that snare drum and the energy that it has. It's incredible. Cool, right? So here's an example of that exact kind of snare slap delay concept applied to a song I'm currently working on. So this is very simple. Just like the previous one, I simply duplicated the snare audio track and I added the delay directly to that parallel track with the mix obviously at 100%. So this is the fully slap back delay sound. Now I've got this delay at 140 milliseconds. I just went single instead of double because I don't need it to be wide, and then zero on the feedback, and I've got the drive cranked. Then I also added a simple room reverb to this delay chain so it adds some extra space to the sound. Put the original snare and the slapback parallel track together and you've got this sound. So those are the 6 best delay effects for indie productions, according to yours truly. Now if you enjoyed this video and you really want to set yourself up for music production greatness, then go grab yourself a copy of my free guide called The 5 Steps to a Spotify Level Production. This guide will give you an actionable framework on how to build out your song from start, from just a kernel of an idea, and then flesh it out, build it out, take it through this 5-step process, and then make that song so good it belongs in an official Spotify playlist, or if it was placed in a top playlist on Spotify, it would be a natural fit, like it belongs there. So that is the end of the video, and why don't I just drag this out for forever? I could just keep talking and bore you to death, or you could just click away. That would be cool too. And I'm just gonna probably fade this out. I don't know why I keep talking. This is terrible. I need food, I'm hungry. I could use really use some Panda Express right now.